Well, Place for People had four paintings of mine. And these are sort of designed as pairs of companion pieces, the two pairs. So, about waiting and wandering, the first, and revolving routes, the third, are companion pieces. Whereas Speaking Street and City for Sale are another pair. Well, in a way, it was a sort of for search of the self. And as I said, that it was confessional in some measure, but also referring to both past and present. In a way, they were all about certain kind of journeys, and also they were open-ended, that they would connect, not only with each other, but they would connect with even other works of mine, or even make reference to other works that I admire. It's also a continuation of the kind of quotation that I had begun with returning home after long absence, in which I had brought in, you know, a tree from a Mughal painting, image of the Prophet from a Persian miniature, and photograph of my mother, plus all other things which I had sort of cooked up or concocted. So these were an extension of that idea. One idea was to bring in as many, let us say, situations as possible. Could one deal with more than one? Simply to, let us say, think in terms of painting both the inside and the outside at the same time. That is how, in fact, the idea of about waiting and wandering emerged. When I was painting, I had used a part of the house that I was living in, and then I went out in the middle of it and was making some drawings of the same house from outside. Just sometimes as simple as that, you know, and they thought, oh, why not? And then it was a journey to something like places, both lived and imagined, or even known and desired, or perhaps physically experienced and dreamt. This is the kind of a companionship that I was seeking. And that, I mean, that's an old hobby horse. It's a kind of a situation that I have tried to articulate in most of my work. So, waiting and wandering sort of emerged from that. And there the quotations are, let's say, the nude woman on the right is from Bathers of Ingres. The Japanese character is perhaps from Utamaro, if I am not mistaken. But then there are all other things, you know, my memories of my childhood, like the train that runs through the, you know, countryside. Or the big champa tree with white flowers, you know, which was in my compound. So in a way, all that, and there is a self-portrait of sort, sort of with a backpack waiting for perhaps something. And it was a landscape or houses or architecture of the kind that I knew in my childhood and also while I was in Baroda. So it's kind of a you know, all, I mean, this is making too factual and too simple. And in fact, I once tried to write down in this painting what I was painting, what the few months that I was working on. I thought, let me see whether it works or not, the changes I make, as I go back and forth. Would it work? I mean, would it make sense? And I, after a few months, I finished the painting and then I'd forgotten, and then after a few months I picked up my, I think it was in some diary, and I read it. It sounded like a load of rubbish, you know. Such a nonsense, you know, that I'd written. It meant nothing. It just meant some kind of, you know, record, which had nothing to do with what the painting, in a way, what I was doing. And I realized that it was a wrong move. And I even thought that at one level it was spying on the soul. I think this is something which one has to guard against. The process of work, you know, is so, it's so complex. So it's so unpredictable at times. You know, you design something and you do exactly the opposite. And you come to a point where you realize that, oh, you began with that, and where are you now? You don't know. And the next day, looking at the same painting, you know, you think, oh God, what have I done? And you go back. You start, you restart, you rub off. So it's not like a kind of a linear journey at all. In fact, that is what interests me, that life is not a linear journey, and art is never. It goes into all kinds of nooks and corners. Even when you think of journey, I mean, there are streets which you have never thought you will traverse, and you do. And there are things that would emerge which you never anticipated. And then all together, when it forms some kind of a, you know, what shall I say, you know, they come together, and at some stage, you know, they begin to work with each other. It's very difficult to even describe, you know, how it happens, what happens. And I don't want to make it mysterious, in the sense that it's not just a simple mystery, it's the whole process of working. It's like that. And if it were not so, there'll be no fun in working, you know. That's all that makes you do things which you want. So you plan out something, and let's say, well, I'm describing a painting, or I can even, after having done the painting, I describe it again. Both of them really sometimes fall flat, until you really encounter it. You have to actually experience it. And at some level, you must make your own journey. I have to make journey in my own painting, as I do in other people's work.